Good morning, everyone. Let me do this very quickly before we get started. If you are an earthquake newbie, please write the word newbie in your comment. Yes, if you are an earthquake newbie, please write the word newbie in your comment. We want to show special empathy for you. If that applies to you, welcome everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Headlines. Yesterday we announced that there was going to be an earthquake drill, and look at what happened. That's not fun. Today there's going to be a drill of pretending that an airline bursts open, a plane bursts open with cash falling down all over the city. So maybe that'll happen later on today. That was a bad joke. Good morning, everyone. Today is Tuesday, September 20th, and this happened. This happened. We had a major, major earthquake yesterday. Before we get into the statistics and all that good stuff, I want to know how you guys are doing. I see that Rod is an earthquake newbie. Welcome to the world of the shaken. I hope you were not too startled. Let's see what else we have. I know that my dear friend Claude is a newbie as well. I remember my first one. It was not fun. Seriously, I hope everybody that is watching is okay. These things are so startling, it's not even funny. So today, Jill says, wow, what a shaker. No damage here in El Centro, in my barrio. I was yesterday, and my earthquake alarm went off, warning me of the quake in Mexico. Love technology. Oh, dear. Let's see. Patty says, 3 aftershocks this morning, already destruction hotels. I've been sick, Paco, Luna, and beautiful peeps. Yes, I've been kind of dizzy since yesterday. Bob is another newbie. I hope this was not too crazy for you. Sly is a newbie. Oh my God, Rod is a newbie. Not good. Anyhow, let us dive into this. I will gladly tell you where I was. I was sitting right here at my desk, and all of a sudden it started happening. And I tried to get up from my chair, and I had a hard time getting up, and I heard, I have a metal sculpture right where my thumb is. It's a small, very inexpensive and very cheaply made male torso that I bought on eBay a million years ago. It fell on the ground and made a big clonk noise. I managed to walk to the window, and right as I got to the window, I saw that the Coca-Cola truck was driving by, and it was wobbling horribly. This is pretty much the strongest earthquake that I have ever felt. So let's go back to your comments in a little while, but first let me show you some statistics and some news about what happened, what we know, and we'll take it from there. For starters, yesterday was September 19, a date that is becoming increasingly significant in Mexico. You see, it was September 19 when a magnitude 8.1 earthquake left behind destruction and death back in 1985. Then it was also in September 19 when a 7.1 also took people by surprise in 2017. What are the odds that we would have another major earthquake on the same date this year? It is actually 0.00075%, according to statisticians from Mexico's National Autonomous University. But it happened. It was 1:05 p.m. yesterday, less than an hour after the national earthquake drill that was established to commemorate the past major earthquakes on this date, that a 7.7 magnitude earthquake, yes, it is 7.7. The numbers have been up and down, but it has now been confirmed that it was a 7.7 magnitude with an epicenter 63 kilometers south of Michoacán, shook the center of Mexico, claiming two lives in Manzanillo, south of Puerto Vallarta, and provoking structural damage in buildings in our city and elsewhere. And the photograph that you're looking at is a hill club in Manzanillo, where a person unfortunately was trapped in a gym, and when its structure fell down, the person died, and another person, a woman, died also in the same city when a wall crumbled over her at a department store. This is, yesterday's earthquake was, rather, the third strongest in 65 years, according to the National Earthquake Center, only topped by the aforementioned 1995 and 2017 earthquakes. And all three occurred on the same date. Is that spooky? You can definitely say that. In other numbers, in the past 250 years, Mexico has registered five big earthquakes, and according to records, a magnitude 7.5 or higher occurs every 10 years in our country in average. As of 7 a.m. this morning, a total of 692 aftershocks have been registered. The strongest one with a magnitude of 5.8 that took place approximately at 3:20 a.m. And I was awake for that one. I always have a difficult time sleeping through these things because I'm afraid that something is going to happen any minute. And lo and behold, I was up at that time and I felt the bed shaking. Luna quickly ran under the bed and I tried to comfort her as much as I could, but I failed, unfortunately. She was really frightened. Here in Puerto Vallarta, you'd think it was older buildings that were damaged. Well, think again. This image shows the Portofino condos in Marina Vallarta with major cracks along six or seven of their flights, their stories. The Sheraton Hotel showed cracks, while the recently built Hotel Mio near Los Tules registered broken windows. There's a video out there of windows also breaking at the El Faro bar in Marina Vallarta. And there's a video, a very bad video out there, but a very eerie one of an infinity pool on top of a tall building near the hotel zone where the water is spilling off the sides of the building from their rooftop infinity pool. Fortunately, however, no major damages have been registered, although I am sure that structural inspectors will have to get to these buildings at some point in the near future. To stir the pudding even further, and in conjunction with yesterday's earthquake, volcanic activity has been detected in the Popocatépetl volcano near Mexico City and the Nevado de Colima near the city of Colima. In Mexico City, they're expecting a bit of ashfall, while the Nevado de Colima is emitting gas onto the atmosphere. And this is probably, I'm going to leave you with a link for this video. of one of the Walmarts here in town. I think it looks like the one in near the Maritime Terminal where panic unfolded as the earthquake was going on. It was taken at the cash register, and all of a sudden, people started running out of the store with their stuff, and it was that's what it was. This is what went on. So I am going to stop with the news because there's really very little else to report. Just about everything else that has been going on in the past 24 hours has had to do with the earthquake. So I'm going to hold on to this, to your comments in a second. And first, we're going to take a look at the weather forecast and we'll take it from there. Oh, I'm not even touching this one. Human trafficking is apparently okay if your favorite politician is the one doing it. Don't get me started with that. Well, no, don't get me started with that. It is 27 degrees, feels like 30. Humidity is at 85%. Our temperature in Fahrenheit degrees is 80. And our weather forecast, according to our snarky friend, says rain and humidity throughout the day today with a high of 30 and a low of 24. Tomorrow, Wednesday, more rain and more humidity with a high of 29 and a low of 24. And Thursday, rain in the morning and afternoon with a high of 30 and a low of 25. As far as other headlines that I want to share with you today, I figured we would throw at least one that has nothing to do with the earthquake. This article in Huffington Post's pays tribute to a handful of traditional Mexican cooking utensils, as described by someone who grew up with them at home. I'm going to share the link to this article in the show notes for you to visit it, and maybe we can revisit some of these items in the future if you're not familiar with them. Because you may want to be familiar with them as English-speaking locals. And of course, we have been announcing that we're going to have a get together in a couple of days. This is going to be at Whiskey Kitchen, and it'll be a lot of fun. So if you have nothing else to do on Thursday afternoon from 6 to 8, join us at Whiskey Kitchen Versailles, where a couple of cluster members are going to share a very wonderful and special surprise with all of us. So now let's see what you guys are thinking of, what your questions are, what your comments are, and we will take it from there. I see a lot of good mornings. We've acknowledged some of you newbies. If I failed to acknowledge you, again, welcome to the world of the shaken. And it's not a pleasant feeling. I was telling some friends that I suffered from childhood epilepsy, and every time I feel an earthquake, it just stirs bad memories for me and makes me feel very, very uneasy. So let's see what we have. We have also good wishes from friends that are watching from elsewhere. Thank you very much, Kimberly. This is much appreciated. Let's see. I think we can get rid of this one. Doink. Let's see what else we have. What a wild ride yesterday. My house was swinging back and forth. Thought it was a vertigo attack at first, but no. Some people experience vertigo even after the quake is over. I know that at times, I mean, I've been very mindful of whether I feel something is moving or not. So it's kind of like a hangover, I suppose. Let's see what else we have. Good mornings. Hope all of you are okay, says Margaret Barrett. That makes two of us. Oh, Raymond. Puerto Vallarta rocks. Literally, I love it. Well, you know how I feel about these things, Raymond.
It's the end of the world as we know it.
There you go. Let's see what else we have. Brian says, happy birthday to my amazing husband, Chris. Chris, happy birthday. I hope you have a wonderful wonderful birthday today. Let's see. I'm taking my time with your comments today because I want to acknowledge as many as I can. Bill says, good morning, Cluster from Shaken Up Versailles. Ha! Brian says, newbie and scared shitless, felt like we were on a boat in rough seas in our ninth floor apartment. Brian, I am almost certain if you have an infinity pool at the top of your buildings, and based on your description of where you guys live, I think it was your building that I saw on a video where water was falling from the roof, clearly coming down from a swimming pool. Joey says, second I felt here in PV, first was about 10 years back. I was at the Oasis del Jori. I remember that one, Joey. I remember that one. I was in the Olas Altas area, and I remember some people getting all wigged out. For me, this is the strongest I've ever felt. And, you know, this is after having lived almost a decade in Mexico City. I never imagined that I would feel a stronger one here in Puerto Vallarta. Kathleen's a newbie. Oh my goodness, I hope you guys are okay, and I hope you're enjoying your time away from Licks. I've been reading on social media that you guys closed down for a well-deserved vacation. I hope you are charging your batteries. Dale, you are correct. I failed to put the Whiskey Kitchen event in the show notes. I will do it today without failure. And if you want to find it, you can also find it in our Facebook page right at the beginning of it. Bill says, I've never felt one like that. Very disconcerting to feel the ground rolling. As far as I know, and I know this from living in Mexico City for so many years, there are two basic types of quakes. The ones that go like this, in Spanish we call them oscilatorio because they oscillate. And the ones that go like this, which we call in Spanish, trepidatorio. So yesterday's was obviously an oscillatorio. Oscillatorio, it oscillated. Let's see what else. Oh no, Amiga Luisa's cat was a newbie. Da, 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 da. our tie-dye guru, our resident tie-dye guru, whom I'm going to interview today, by the way, says, yesterday was crazy when I first felt it. I was congratulating my herb. Then I realized it was just an earthquake. I love it. I love it. Let's see what else. Terry's another newbie. Welcome to the Shaken. Sly says, minor damage to my condo, but the condo tower has some damage. Yes, I hear you. Vince says, 7.7 in Colima. What was it in PV? I have no idea, Vince, but it was pretty strong. When these things are reported, they are reported at the epicenter. So if the epicenter was near Colima, that's why we're recording 7.7. There's a cue. Did your cat give you any indication when we lived in Switzerland and had a quake? My cat gave me a warning by acting really weird. Actually, no, Tracy. Luna was chilling in her under the bed hideaway as usual. That's what she does through the afternoon. She goes under my bed. So if she noticed it or if she sensed it, she didn't send me a memo, unfortunately. Claude says, I thought our pet would warn us of a coming earthquake. All three slept through it. What the fuck? I hear you. Let's see. Native Californian here, says Ted. Have been through many earthquakes before. Yesterday was definitely the scariest one I've experienced. I hear you. Kelly woke up for the 3 a.m. Makes two of us. There's a cue. Anybody else experience vertigo? I'm experiencing extreme vertigo. I don't know if I have vertigo right now. I think I have like my own paranoid induced dizziness because I'm thinking, I'm constantly looking around me and seeing if things are moving. So I'm sure that I am making my body feel vertigo. Let's see. Ah, yes, that's what I thought. That was her complex with the pool splashing and splashing. Thankfully, the pools are closed until 2 p.m. or on Mondays for cleaning. Oh, my goodness. Imagine being swimming at an infinity pool on top of a tall building, and all of a sudden you get the shakes. Not fun. Oh, please get started with that. Paco would love to get your take on it. If you are referring, Dave, to what is happening with what happened at Martha's Vineyard, I'd rather not touch that because it is complicated. And from someone who lives outside of the United States, it's difficult to understand. And the part that is difficult to understand is how are people letting this happen? And this is clearly not the place or time to get into that. I just wish I could understand, how is this possible? How is this allowed to happen? So Sheraton Bougainvillea has had some crash. This is what I read, Sharon, although not major cracks. They had cracks like other buildings had cracks. I did read in one of the news items that when civil protection wanted or attempted to enter the building to do their inspection, the hotel said no. We've got it covered, and I don't know exactly what that means either. Unfortunately, the U.S. consulate is having a meeting on Thursday afternoon. That's right. Okay, well, I don't know what time the meeting ends. Our get together is from 6 to 8. Hopefully there's not an overlap there. Let's see what else. Sherry says, my molcajete is decoration more than utilitarian, but I had good intentions when I bought it. See, the thing to know about molcajetes and clay ceramic pottery, Sherry, is that they have to be primed, because otherwise, if they're not primed, food prepared with them is going to taste really yucky. So maybe that's what I meant earlier when I said let us maybe find some time in the future to talk about these chingaderas. Let's see. Lots of good wishes. Thank you very much for that. Much appreciated. Jacqueline says the water from the pool was on the Soho condos. I believe we may be talking about the same place. I forget the names of the condo buildings myself, or I don't make it a point to remember them. Let's see. Structural inspectors are checking my building in Díaz Ordaz as we speak. Apparently some cracks that I hadn't noticed yesterday. My landlord was inspecting our building. Lona asks, was there any tsunami action observed? The answer is not that I'm aware of. There was a warning that was generated in the United States, a tsunami warning, but then the Mexican Earthquake Center said there's no tsunami. And I didn't see any tsunami activity, although the local authorities took precaution and made announcements for people to stay away from the beach and the ocean just in case. Marie chimes in. My pup Lucy started racing around the apartment and barking like crazy before I felt the first tremor. Animals know before we do. Not the ones that are taking a nap. I think Luna was sleeping through it. Why bring up politics here, says Patty Armstrong. Patty, we talk about Mexican politics all the time, and we will continue to do so. But I will respectfully respect our space and not talk about politics from other countries. I was just answering a question as concisely and as much as I could, trying to avoid a discussion. But we will definitely talk about Mexican politics here. You know, there are politics in different countries, you know. Let's see. I love it when you guys write these comments, no sound, because ultimately, unless a lot of people are mentioning no sound, there's very little. In fact, there's nothing I can do to do something about your internet service. What day, Paco, would love to meet you? If this is about our get together, it's in a couple of days. It's going to be at Whiskey Kitchen. Hopefully you can be there. And we will have the information in the show notes. This time I will definitely put it there. I find that very strange that Protection Civil could not go in the Sheraton, even if they say that they have it covered. They should have forced it themselves. What happens if there was a fire? They got that covered. Also, what are they hiding? That's a great commentary, Michael. Unfortunately, I am neither a member of Protección Civil, nor am I affiliated with the Sheraton, so I cannot comment on your comment. But yeah, you gotta wonder why it was reported that way. Friday at Whiskey Kitchen? No, Thursday at Whiskey Kitchen. Let's see. And I think we are done. We are done with your comments. We are done with our coverage of the earthquake. I hope we are done with our coverage of the earthquake. Again, as always, thank you very much for joining me here at Coffee and Headlines. It is comforting to know that that you guys are okay. For those of you that experienced the earthquake for the first time, well, what can I tell you? This is what it feels like. Now you know. And let's hope that we will not have to endure something like that anytime soon again. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining me. Stay safe, stay happy, stay kind, and stay in touch. And I'll see you again tomorrow.